Hello, and welcome to the 2025 MicroGNext Selection Show. My name is Jamie Semple, the NASA Activity Manager for MicroGNext here at Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. We are thrilled to announce the team selected for the 11th MicroGNext Challenge. Student teams from across the nation have developed design solutions for one of three challenges, focusing on lunar surface operations, search and rescue, and microgravity operations. Our team was very impressed with the many innovative approaches we received as part of the proposal submissions. We are looking forward to working with all the teams this year as you seek to create solutions for future NASA missions. Before we get to the selections, I'd like to introduce Isidro Reyna from the Space Operations Mission Directorate.
Hi, I'm Isidro Reyna, and I lead communications and engagement in the Space Operations Mission Directorate at NASA headquarters. In space operations, we've been honored to support and work with MicroGNext throughout the past 10 years. Our space ops team manages NASA's current and future space operations in and beyond low Earth orbit. Ensuring continuous presence in low Earth orbit is vital for scientific discovery, technology development, and international collaboration. By participating in student design challenges, you are directly contributing to NASA's missions. And I am excited to be part of welcoming the student team selected to advance for the 11th year of the MicroGNext Challenge. Before we get to the selections, let's learn more about MicroGNext.
A project coordinator for student design challenges. The MicroGNext challenges this year were created in collaboration with the EVA Tools Group here at NASA's Johnson Space Center and the Search and Rescue Office out of Goddard Space Flight Center. To tell us a little bit more about our first challenge, here is Isha Ng to describe the details of the contact sampling device.
Hi, my name is Isha Ng, and I'm an EVA Tools engineer here at Johnson Space Center. The first challenge this year is the contact sampling device, where students were tasked with designing a device to allow a suited astronaut to collect a contact sample of regolith from the lunar surface. I'd like to welcome the following teams that have been selected to advance for the contact sampling device challenge.
Hi, I'm Flight Director Nicole McElroy, also known as VistaFlight. I'm really excited to welcome the Columbia Space Initiative from my alma mater, Columbia University. Congratulations and welcome to MicroGNext.
Hi, I'm Allison Porter, an integrated human loop test engineer at NASA. I'd like to welcome Team Herbie from my alma mater, UNL. Congrats and go Big Red.
Hi, I'm Katie Limigood, and I'm the HLS Crew Health and Performance Insight Deputy Lead here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. I'd like to welcome the Tulsa Contact Sampler from my alma mater, the University of Tulsa. Congratulations and Rain Kane.
Hello, I'm April Blackwell, an aerospace engineer and ISS flight controller here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. I'd like to welcome the Next Level Devils from my alma mater, Arizona State University. Let's go, Devils!
Hi, my name is Caleb Cram. I'm a human performance engineer at Johnson Space Center, and I'd like to welcome the microgravity research team from my alma mater, Boise State University. Go Broncos!
Hello, my name is John Davis Jr. I'm a STEM education specialist here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. I would like to congratulate Southland Space Tigers from Clemson University. Go Tigers!
Hi, I'm Haley Spears, a safety engineer here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. I'd like to welcome Team Cersei from my alma mater, the University of South Florida. Go Bulls!
Hi, I'm Allison Porter, an integrated human-in-the-loop engineer at NASA Johnson Space Center. I'd like to welcome Team Thoth from UNL, my alma mater. Congrats and go Big Red.
Hi, I'm Tim Hall, Strategic Communications Manager for the EHP program here at Johnson Space Center. I'd like to congratulate and welcome the Mountaineers from my alma mater, West Virginia University. Congratulations and good luck going forward. Let's go, Mountaineers.
Congratulations to the contact sampling teams. Next, I'd like to introduce Kelly DeReese to share details on the soft goods attachment device.
Hi, I'm Kelly DeReese, an EVA tools engineer here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. For the soft goods attachment device, students submitted designs of an EVA tool or a suite of tools that can be used to attach two overlapping pieces of soft goods together while accessing only one side of the material. Congratulations to the following team selected for the soft goods attachment device.
Hello, I'm Jamarius Reed, a systems engineer at NASA's Johnson Space Center. It is an honor to welcome Team SEAM of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. Go Eagles.
I'm Garrett Hain, flight director here at NASA. I'd like to welcome Team Astra from my alma mater, Virginia Tech. Congratulations, go Hokies.
Hi, I'm Kaylee Mims, an education specialist here at NASA's Johnson Space Center. I'm super excited to welcome Team Falcons from Cerritos College. Congrats, guys.
Hi, I'm Katie Livingood, and I'm the HLS Crew Health and Performance Deputy Insight Lead at NASA's Johnson Space Center. Congratulations to the Astro Anchors from Grand Valley State University.
Hey there, my name is Ryan Landon, and I work at Johnson Space Center managing all of the research we do on ISS. I'd like to just take a minute and welcome the Space Cowgirls from my alma mater, University of Wyoming. Go Pokes!
Hello, my name is John Davis Jr., a STEM education specialist here at NASA Johnson Space Center. I'd like to congratulate Team Albert X from Florida Polytechnic University. Go Phoenix!
Congratulations to the team selected for the Soft Goods Challenge. Lastly, Cody Kelly will introduce the challenge description for the Safety Challenge.
Howdy, my name is Cody Kelly. I'm the National Affairs Manager with the Search and Rescue Mission Office from the Goddard Space Flight Center. This year, we're going to talk about the Safety Challenge, which is a student challenge for students to design an autonomous system to detect, decode, and provide information about the health and safety of the Artemis capsule following its return from the moon on Artemis II. We're going to be looking at the 406 megahertz signals that are a SARSAT signal, or the Search and Rescue Satellite Aided Tracking signal that allows for tracking of the capsule anywhere in the world, as well as a localized homing signal that provides basically vectoring for search and rescue forces during the rescue and recovery phases of the mission. This piece of hardware is going to be critically important to allow us to know, is the capsule transmitting when we go up and do crew recovery, as well as providing data from a long range of the capsule to know where it's at during that rescue and recovery phase. And congratulations to the following universities that were selected for this year's Safety Challenge.
Hi, I'm Dr. Saraji Jalauso. I'm an OSTEM internship specialist here at JSC, and I want to congratulate Team Aurora from the University of Texas, Dallas. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Stacey Welch, the Digital Collaborations Manager at NASA's Johnson Space Center, and I want to welcome the Sea Aggies from my alma mater, Texas A&M University. Welcome and congratulations. Gig'em.
Hello, I am Jamarius Reed, a systems engineer at NASA's Johnson Space Center. It is an honor to welcome Team SEMAphytes of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, my alma mater. Go Eagles!
Congratulations to all the teams selected to participate in the 2025 MicroGNX Challenge. We look forward to seeing your designs here at NASA's Johnson Space Center during the culminating prototype test week. Lastly, thank you for tuning in to the MicroGNX selection announcement. Goodbye!
Clock is operating. We're underway.
Roger, 0G, and I feel fine.